First of all, we have a bank-wide strategy. The IT strategy is derived from that. It checks the direction in which the business is going in. Maybe the business is consolidating all the, it's focused on consolidation this year. So the IT strategy is supposed to complement that. Yeah, we're going to be centralizing all our systems. So what happens is once the IT basic draft of the IT strategy is formulated, it's sent to us for vetting for the risk management group. And then we highlight the information security needs. We check out which are the key risk areas, what are the key applications. We assign risk ratings to respective applications or respective proposals, which are going to be acquired in the next 2 or 3 years. And then we highlight which are the controls which need to be implemented. We also highlight possible regulatory issues that might crop up, which need to be addressed proactively. It's prepared separately. It's derived from the IT strategy. It's supposed to complement the IT strategy. Like I said, what we do is we basically conduct a bank-wide risk assessment based on the IT strategy. And then we highlight the key risks which the bank is going to be focusing. We call it an IS risk register. But it is pretty much the IS strategy for it, because it sets the roadmap and it sets the guidelines for what controls we're going to be implementing for the next 2 or 3 years. The operational risk area, yeah, that's a good question, because when I'm sitting in risk management, the head of operational risk is sitting right next to me. So basically they do define the key risk indicators, the key risk areas, the operational risk. You know, information security is part of operational risk. It comes under operational risk. So yeah, there's a lot of feedback going on. We actually do get our IS strategy. We take a lot of feedback from operational risk as well. When you're talking about the leakage of areas, yeah, we keep addressing that, with regards to the USB devices, with regards to email, the internet, lately the social networking websites. A lot of banks have started, they've started to recognize the potential for information leakage. Their websites like Facebook and Twitter and all that. So yeah, we've also developed a policy for that. We're going to be rolling it out soon. No, that's not going to work. I honestly don't believe it. If you're going to be blocking social networking websites, the guy is going to go at home and he's going to do what he was going to do anyway. So I think it's more an approach regarding awareness. You have to make the staff aware. There are certain statements about the bank, about the area which you're working on, you don't say on the website. And yeah, you have to make the people understand as well. Because let me tell you, social networking websites are used by banks, especially the marketing departments. When they roll out new products and promotions, so you can't just shut them off. That's a great initiative you're stopping. Formally, we send our IS risk strategy to senior management, but additionally, we have a very user-friendly presentation which is rolled out after every 4 months. And my department also conducts training sessions and awareness sessions for all the staff, and we take a lot of feedback from that. I try to keep the lines of communication open, especially the far-off areas, the interior sense areas, you get a lot of feedback from that. It's easy to sit in my office and say don't do password sharing and all that, but when you're sitting in a branch, you only have 2 staff. So naturally some violations are going to occur. It's always better to know these things are happening. Yeah, I've always tried to keep the lines of communication open. With centralization, obviously there are a lot of benefits. You get a lot of, the reporting is much more easier. The administration is much more easier. With decentralized, of course, there were certain risks, but there were also benefits as well. With decentralized, the administration is much more faster, because you've delegated a lot of the things to the line managers. Of course, what happens is that they take a lot of liberties with the rights and privileges they've been assigned. You get a lot of branches where the guy has pretty much given the whole branch to one person. So that's a lot of issues, apparently. Yeah, so it's a trade-off, honestly. I can't say the decentralized model is completely, there's only disadvantages. There are a lot of advantages with that as well. Because supposing, especially in Pakistan, the branches get cut off. Supposing networking is down. In a decentralized environment, the branch can still function. In a centralized environment, the branch is cut off. If it gets cut off from the central server, the branch is down. You'll have to go back to the paper mode, So there are a lot of advantages with that as well, with regards to the business continuity processes. We have a dedicated unit for business continuity, and what we do is we have a lot of interaction with it. We regularly conduct independent tests of the business continuity plan, and the results are provided to the bank's board risk management committee. They independently check whether the bank's business continuity plan is being checked. That's a requirement by State Bank as well, actually. They do check it when they come. On the disaster recovery side, the data is replicated live to a remote disaster recovery site, and we regularly actually check that the data is being replicated. Just the data is being copied to one place, that's done well. That's just one aspect. We have to actually check the data is working fine. Because yeah, there have been a lot of unfortunate live incidents like that. You assume that the data is there, it's working fine, but then it doesn't work. Yeah, so just to avoid that kind of scenario. Internet banking, yeah, there are a lot of risks associated with internet banking, I'll say that. But they said the same thing about ATMs as well. They said, okay, there's a machine in which cash is coming out, that's a whole new risk area. So no, I wouldn't say that. Actually, internet banking is that depends on the organization. I mean, the type of if you're simply allowing people to check their account statements and all that, yeah, I think it's pretty much it's a great channel. It's very convenient for the customer as well. The bank should be willing to take that amount of risk. But of course, there are a lot of new frauds which are coming out as well. You know, we previously used to think that if you had a user ID and a password and a token, a two-factor authentication, you were pretty much secure. Well, the new type of malware which is coming out, that completely bypasses it. It doesn't matter if you have biometrics or anything. It is able to commit fraud on the fly, actually. So, you know, it's a race with no finishing line. You know, they're going to be coming up with new fraud. You're going to be coming up with new controls. I think the human element, you know, you can't ignore the human element. More so than any, when you're combining any application or networking or data centers, the human element really comes up, the cultural element. And yes, you will see a lot of issues cropping up. Especially with regards to the potential for fraud. You know, whenever mergers and acquisitions happen, people get very, very nervous regarding their job security. So you'll automatically see a lot of password sharing going on, a lot of information leakage going on. People are going to be thinking, I'm going to be losing my job soon. I might as well copy all the data. Yeah, you do see that a lot of happen. Infrastructurally speaking, I think it is definitely, they're starting to tackle the challenge. They are starting to recognize. You know, a lot of fraud has started to occur, which is exclusively information security focused. They've started to realize that their response capabilities aren't up to the mark. Previously, what they used to do, they would get the network administrator guy and say, okay, now from now on, you're the IT security guy as well. But they have started to notice that, okay, that's not enough. You need to have a dedicated function, even if it's just one guy. And they've also started to notice that it's not effective to have him reporting to the CIO or the IT head, because he usually gets shut down whenever he tries to say something anywhere, stop anything or any application. So I'm seeing a lot of areas where they're changing the reporting line as well. Just take my example, I report to the risk management function. I'm independent from IT. So yeah, they have started. It's gradually occurring. I'm not saying it's full-fledged ahead, but they have started to see the benefit of having a fully mature information security function. Well, you know, Pakistan has, there are certain risks in Pakistan, which of course is social and geographical risk, especially you can have it right here, the riots and the flooding. Yeah, so the location, the geographical risks, especially for the far off branches, for the far off areas where suddenly violence can erupt. Yeah, so that's a lot of areas, you know, where you're taking your backups properly, your infrastructure is strong enough to sustain that. They have started to, you know, for branches, a lot of banks, they used to take shortcuts. They would not have dedicated data centers. They would put the server in the basement or something. So yeah, that's a lot of concern. They have now started to see that it's quite a loss for that. Yeah, and another thing is, I would say another concern for banks is definitely branchless banking, because they've started to see the potential of this market. They've started to, and the information they haven't, unfortunately, what something has always happens, you take an initiative and information security is always seen as something which is stopping, and they come in at the end, okay, now kindly plug in the security holes. So branchless banking is another risk area which is being addressed. And after that, I would say that, the portable devices, yeah, that is a hassle. You know, everybody loves the iPad or the iPods. And then, especially senior management, you know, try convincing the CEO that you shouldn't connect your personal iPod or something to the bank's laptops or something. Yeah, that is another security nightmare. In my opinion, these are the three most security.